What's good, folks? It's Nightmare Frame here with a new Warframe video coming at you with a small guide in melee modding. I will go over how damage works and a look at different types of damage multipliers. Also here to explain what mods work together and when you should use certain mods and why they make the build what it is. Let's have a look at the main elements that will be found in 90% of all the melee builds, and that's damage, crits, and status. Damage can scale from raw damage mods like pressure point to physical damage and elemental mods. Let's talk a little bit about raw damage, starting with condition overload and why this mod takes over in most melee builds rather than using pressure point or prime pressure point. Condition overload provides stacking additive damage with each status effect on a target. That means the melee doesn't have to be the one applying the status effect, but as long as the target itself has some status effects, you will deal more damage. This is why you see people running utility weapons like the Nucor and Zhakti as primers for the damage increase. Now again, this damage is additive, not multiplicative. This means running both condition overload and prime pressure point will lead you to have diminishing returns. Basically, too much of one thing will yield little to no significant increase in damage. Pressure point will only give your initial strikes more damage, but won't scale as well. That's why running both of these is never a good idea, but there are some special cases where you'll benefit from having both. Now, dealing with physical damage types, impact, puncture, and slash, or commonly known as IPS, each of these physical damage types have their own status effects, but impact and puncture unfortunately aren't as useful as slash. These two will only benefit you in terms of boosting condition overload's damage scaling. Slash is the most devastating physical damage type as it scales better and just deals a lot more damage. Slash and its status effect are two different things. Slash provides you with the status effect called bleed. It's a damage over time that stacks. Each single stack has its own timed instance. It scales off your raw melee damage mods and faction damage mods, and not physical damage type mods like Buzzkill. Physical damage mods make the melee have a higher priority to proc that said damage type. Bleed damage is dealt as true damage. True damage ignores all forms of defenses. Even though it struggles to bypass shields, impact procs will help you deal with shields. Onto elemental mods. Elemental mods are another instance of damage that scale from your raw damage and faction damage mods, and some elements pair well with physical damage types. Each type of elemental damage will deal more damage to a certain type of defense, for example, ferrite armor, which is found on most Grineer units. It will take 75% more damage from corrosive. Just like physical damage types, elements and their status effects are two different things. Onto faction damage mods. For the love of God, do not underestimate the power of faction damage mods. It allows you to deal multiplicative damage towards the faction you're up against, especially if you pair it up with slash and a few elements. The best combos for faction mods are slash, toxin, electricity, and heat. These can stack on top of each other and have their own instance of damage that scales from raw damage and faction damage mods. However, with heat, you can continue to build up stacks that will scale up linearly, but the stacks will combine into one damage ramp up. Basically, all stacks will add up to the one burn tick over time. It's a unique effect, especially when paired with a faction mod. This will help you deal insane multiplicative damage regardless of the enemy's immunities. These are not the only ways to increase damage. Moving on to crits. Critical chance and crit multipliers. The go-to mods for crits on melees are Blood Rush and Sacrificial Steel. Blood Rush scales your weapon-based critical chance with the amount of combo you have built up, reaching 660% crit chance at maximum melee combo, so it won't start giving you any bonuses till you have some combo. Adding mods like Sacrificial Steel or True Steel, which are raw crit chance mods, will work as an additive bonus, so you won't gain much benefit by doing this. you're better off modding for other types of damage multipliers, like elemental combos or faction mods. But then we have mods like the Gladiator set, where they provide you with utility, damage, and with a set effect similar to Blood Rush. This is another instance of a critical chance increase that works similar to Blood Rush and does pair real well with the mod. But this doesn't mean sacrificial mods are bad. Heavy attack builds benefit more from sacrificial steel, while combo builds benefit more from Blood Rush, since heavy attacks need that instant boost of crits from the get-go. However, there are unique builds that combine combo with heavy attacks. I will get to that, no worries. Crits have three different tiers. Your raw damage will be seen as white damage, while a crit will change that color to yellow. Once your critical chance hits a certain threshold, it'll change colors going from orange to red. But high crits doesn't always mean more damage, because adding crits on top of each other will also have diminishing returns. So that's why you need other sources of damage boosts. Critical multipliers will boost your crit damage output, but then bonus elemental damage, faction damage, raw damage buildup, and even other sources of buffs will complement your crits for you to deal even more damage. Let's have a look at status chance and status effects. Status chance grants your physical damage types and elements a higher chance to proc their respective status effects. But there's something that confuses people a little bit, and that's proc priority and status chance. Since IPS bias has been removed, modding for elements has changed slightly. That means there's no physical damage types having a higher chance to proc than elements. So whichever damage type has the highest value, this gives it a higher priority to proc. And the status chance determines the rate of the procs, while the proc priority determines which damage type gets to proc more often. I hope this makes sense. Also, for example, even if your weapon doesn't deal slash, there are melee stances with combos that force proc slash, which can allow you to deal slash and bleed enemies, even though your weapon doesn't have that particular physical damage type. And one of the go-to mods for melees right now is Weeping Wounds. Now, why is this mod worth using? Like Blood Rush, it increases your status chance with your combo multiplier. And since you can go above 100% status chance, this makes melees even more devastating. Just a small reminder, elemental damage and elemental status effects are two different things. For example, corrosive damage is its own thing, and even if the weapon has 0% status chance, as long as you have the element on the weapon, it will deal 75% more damage to ferrite armor. Alright, now that you have an idea of some of the key things to increase damage, let's go over a little on combo multipliers, how to utilize and maintain them. Combo Counter allows you to maintain the mod buffs from Blood Rush, Weeping Wounds, and the Gladiator set bonus, and also increases the damage from heavy attacks, exalted weapons, and pseudo-exalted weapons. Combo Counter is gained from attacking something that can take damage, but will disappear completely if you don't hit something within 5 seconds. There are a few mods that increase your combo duration and give you that extra chance to gain more combo. And if you have modular melees, aka Zaws, they have an arcane that increases your chance to gain combo. The Focus School Neromon has a node called Power Spike. This will have your combo decay over time rather than disappearing completely. Also, within the combo system, there's something that confuses people, and that's melee combo efficiency. This refers to the amount of combo you use up with each heavy attack. That's it, nothing special. Mods like Focus Energy give you that slight boost in combo efficiency, and so does the Focus School Xenoric. Combo efficiency can also be found on Rivens. Combo efficiency itself caps at 90%. This means you consume only one charge of a combo counter with a heavy attack. Initial combo, on the other hand, gives you a head start in your combo, which benefits heavy attack builds a lot more than combo builds. Some stances have multi-strike combos, which help build up combo faster and is a DPS increase. Range mods are another huge factor when it comes to building up combo and dealing damage. More target hits equals faster combo and more DPS. Now, in terms of modding, I cannot show you every melee, but let's take a look at ways to mod weapons. Whatever you see here in terms of modding can be applied to literally any melee. Stances can be important for the builds, as they offer force procs, multi-strike combos, and burst damage. But if you're planning for casual modding, then this video isn't for you. Here we start off with Condition Overload for the scaling additive damage with each status effect on a target. Blood Rush for the scaling crit chance with your combo. Primed Reach for the increase in range to hit multiple targets to build up your combo faster. And of course, deal damage in a wider area. Range is important, don't forget this. Berserker for the scaling attack speed when critting. Organ Shatter for the critical multiplier. Weeping Wounds for the scaling status chance per combo, providing consistent and definite procs. This is the basic for any melee right here. But since I will be modding for Corrosive on this particular build, I will use Prime Fever Strike and Shocking Touch to form Corrosive. Corrosive is better off being the dominant damage type when modding for it. It's just better for burst DPS against armored units. Never mod for an extra element. It may seem like a damage increase on paper, but you will be better off without it. Only time where you'll have an extra element if the weapon itself has an innate element. But when modding for Viral, you need to balance the elemental mod capacity. The best physical damage type that pairs well and scales better with Viral is Slash. Viral deals multiplicative health damage, capping at 325% at 10 stacks. And since bleeds deal true damage, that will increase the damage output. So for the toxin and cold combination, you want to have one ranked up with 1 point and the other unranked. Or sometimes both of them ranked up once or both unranked, depending on the slash distribution. You want the slash to be the dominant damage type. Now let's go to the non-elemental build with slash and smite mod. It's the basic melee build, but instead of running elements, you use a smite mod, and the last mod can be whatever you want. More crit damage, range, attack speed, and yes, and in this case, even primed pressure point. It is weird, but this is used if you aren't going to use a primer, meaning a smite setup without a utility weapon. This is the time where prime pressure point and condition overload would actually pair well with each other. But if you're going to use a utility weapon that procs multiple status effects to boost condition overload, I highly recommend to not use prime pressure point for your smite setups. Now, the smite setups can come in many forms. The smite and heat, the smite and toxin, and the smite and electric combo, doing 2 to 3 times more damage. You can either balance your slash on the weapons and the single elements or go full elements with smite. There are some weapons that have base elements like Sylvan Aegis, Jadkuzar, Oma, Seti Lacera, and so much more. They can offer some of the most highest DPS when it comes to melee modding. They can offer you some amazing powerful combos. Here you can see I have used the slash and toxin smite combo to easily do a 5-hour survival in Steel Path and just destroying every single enemy easily. And for the heavy attack builds, they are mostly built for raw damage, initial combos, and raw crit. Heavy attack builds are mostly for weapons that force proc slash to bleed enemies to death with one swing. The stances have nothing to do with heavy attacks, only the weapon type. So the best heavy attack weapons for force slash procs are scythes, Nikanas, single daggers, tomfas, machetes, rapiers, and whips. Machetes have the most unique type of heavy attacks. You perform a spin motion that bleeds enemies and staggers them and puts them in a dazed state, where they're open to finishers and vulnerable to stealth multipliers, which is another form of true damage. Finishers and stealth multipliers both scale from weapon damage, crits, and other forms of multipliers. To emulate stealth multipliers, you can use a secondary called Zakti, a Zaw Arcane called Exodia Hunt, machete heavy attacks, and Warframe abilities. These allow you to fluctuate damage numbers to the next level, and they will scale even more with faction damage mods. But then there are gunblades, which also excel in heavy attacks, but do not force proc slash. They just offer instantaneous burst of damage because you can get headshots easily. Headshot multipliers just add another increase in DPS. Alright, now what if you want to combine the combo build and heavy attack build all in one? Well, That's when you go for the quick and heavy loadout. This is best used on Zaz, since they give you the addition of Exodia Arcanes. It's modded like the combo build, but with a few changes. Instead of Condition Overload, you run Prime Pressure Point, since you want to deal initial damage. And instead of Organ Shatter, you go with Amalgam Organ Shatter for the 30% heavy attack windup speed and 85% critical multiplier. For the Arcane, I'm running Exodia Triumph, which helps you build up combo faster, since you will be using your heavy attacks ever so often. Since you'll use it to build up combo to heavy attack. And now the elemental combo is corrosive with Prime Fever Strike and Focus Energy. Focus Energy gives you 60% electricity and 40% combo efficiency. To make this build work, make sure you're in Xenarik running the Innermite node. This will cap your combo efficiency at 90%, so you will only use up one combo with each heavy attack. You also deal the modded element when you heavy attack. Anyway, this is my update to the new melee modding system. If I missed anything, some great tips and tricks, drop them in the comment section, please. Alright guys, that has been it for me. I do hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you found it informative, feel free to leave a like, share, and subscribe. For more Warframe content, streams, and so much more, do refer to the description. Thanks for watching, and as always, peace.